Hello everyone, how are you all? Students, this is Zia ma'am here and today I'm going to teach you a very important topic and the name of the topic is preposition. Yes students, today I'm going to teach you a very important topic that is all about preposition. Now, this topic preposition is important for all the classes. If I talk honestly, it is very much needed from class 6 to class 12. Okay, so it is very important topic and for which you need to understand the concept. So before you, I brought the very important topic that is all about preposition. I made my own notes so that I can explain you all and you can easily relate with your own topics which is given in your book. Now first of all, the question comes, what is preposition? What is preposition? So, a preposition is a word used to link nouns, pronouns or phrases to other words within a sentence. Now, they act to connect people, objects, time and locations of a sentence. Right? Also, students, prepositions are usually short words. They are short words, two-letter words, three-letter words, but it is very short, but it do play a very major role in English grammar, and they are normally placed directly in front of nouns. In some cases you will find prepositions in front of gerund verbs. Okay, gerund. So when I say gerund, what do you mean by gerund? You might have learned in your English grammar. Gerund means when I speak about this verb plus ing, suppose run. So what would be the gerund word of run? Running. Okay, come, coming, dance, dancing, sing, singing. So after word, like it is a suffix, when we place verb plus ing, this will turn into gerund, right? Now, as I'm giving you lecture, you might be seeing notes as well. A nice way to think about preposition is as the words that help glue means attach a sentence together. They do this by expressing position and movement, possession, time and how an action is completed, right? Now, rules of preposition. There are two important rules which I found about the preposition. Now, the first rule is that to make sentence clear, specific prepositions are needed. We need very specific and very cut-to-cut or targeted prepositions. For example, how can I say that? Now look at my example. Suppose I say two cases I'm using here. I want to see you in the house, Bill. I want to see you in the house now, Bill. Case number one. Case number two is, I want to see you on the house now, Bill. So in the first case, I have used in, and in the second case, I have used on. Now look at this difference. In the house means when I say I want to see you in the house now, Bill. So in the house means Bill should go through the door, walk inside and stand in the hall, right? Now on the house, when I say I want to see you on the house now, Bill. Okay, so you have to on means what? Here on means Bill would need to get a ladder, CD, and climb to the roof where he would be on top of the house. Now previously I told you about rule number one. Now listen to rule number two. The second rule according to my notes is for using preposition is that prepositions are generally followed by nouns or pronouns. So we need to be really careful while using prepositions. Where we are using in, where we are using at, where we are using on. So the same sentences as you have seen in the first case, I have used in, the meaning was different. In the second case, I have used the same sentence, same character, but just I replaced in with on and the meaning, which generated was totally different, right? Now, let me come to the next topic, which is types of prepositions. Now there are three types of preposition which I have jotted down, guys. Now first of all, preposition of time. Now basic examples of preposition, time prepositions include example of time preposition. Tell me, it would be at, on, in, before and after. At, on, in, before and after, right? Now, they are used to help indicate something happened. Yani kuch hua hai, something happened, happens or will happen. Okay, something happened or will happen or about to happen. Example, you can see in my screen. Now, one example I took and I have changed into different categories. Now, look at this. I was born on July 4th, 1990. I'm not talking about myself. Okay. So, I was born on July 4th, 1990. Please underline this. You can see the underline on here. I was born in 1990. In here. I was born at exactly 2 a.m. I was born 2 minutes before my twin brother. Last one. I was born after the Great War happened. So I was born. Now here I'm using the same sentence. But what I'm doing here, I am just changing the set of preposition. In the first sentence, I have used on. In second, I have used in. At, before and after. Now this shows time. Kab? July 4th. When? In 1982. At exactly, before and after. So it is showing ki when? After the Great World War. Okay, before my twin brothers. To ye time samay kab ka tha? That we come to know by preposition of time, right? Next one, students, preposition of place. Preposition of place, right? Now look at this. Now they have been used to indicate position. It is also used to refer to a place where something or someone is located. So it is that something or someone is located. Look at my example. Jane is waiting for you at the bus stop. Where Jane is waiting for me? Jane is waiting for me at the bus stop. So whenever you use the bus stop or any other thing, we use a preposition at. Do you work in an office? Do you work in an office? If I will say, do you work on office? It will look awkward. Do you work after office? What is this, sir? So the correct word usage would be, yahan pe samajhna hai ki prepositions किधर लगाना है, how to insert preposition so that my meaning will come out in a better way and all the people listening me, watching me will be able to understand my conversation. Okay, so that would be concept should be clear. You are standing on my foot. I can't say you are standing in my foot. Hello, what is this? You are standing on my foot, right? Last but not the least is a third category of preposition, which is called as two names, prepositions of motion or prepositions of movement. Now look at this. These sentences have been used to indicate direction. Direction, yes, related to movement, so that they are known as position also of movement or motion. Moving here and there. Examples again. The car drove along the street. By the way, what is drove? Drove is a past tense of drive. Okay. Driving ka past tense hota hai drove. The car drove along the street. So what is preposition of? So what kind of preposition is this? And where is a preposition? First of all, where is a preposition? The preposition is along. Okay, very good. Now what quality of preposition is this? Or what type of preposition is this? This is preposition of motion or movement. Okay. He looked straight into her eyes. She pushed her face towards him. Okay, these are the certain words which is used as preposition, showing as prepositions of motion or movement. Her hair wiped around her face in the wind. So the words like along, into, towards, okay? Along, into, towards, around, this will come under the preposition of movement or the preposition of place. So students, here I ended with the prepositions and I tried my best to explain you about preposition. It is for all the classes. Anybody can refer it, seeing the examples also. You can copy down the notes as well. Thank you and have a very great day, and please do take care of yourself. Thank you.